paper. She throws her bag in the corner and the paper in front of the man, who still pretends he's writing. She leaves the room while taking off her dress.
The power will go off for 2 hours. They want to change the old wires.
He looks at the paper and tries to find a calendar through the papers scattered around him. He goes to the woman's bag, finds her pocket calendar, and checks it.
From tonight.
The sound of water is heard in the bathroom. Someone is taking a shower. The woman's thoughts are heard. It is mixed with the sound of water.
How can I tell him then? How? Well, I wish I could write it down like him so that I don't have to tell him face to face, but this is hard. Very hard. But I should find a way to explain to him before he discovers all the things. The power outage can be a good excuse. Yeah, I should tell him before they connect the old wires. I should start telling him. Telling him that.
Scene 2, first night. Sound of running water stops. Man is searching for a candle in the kitchen. The sound of a quarrel between the man and the woman throwing dishware at each other is heard. The sound is followed by breaking glass.
What happened?
Nothing.
What are you doing? You'll hurt your feet without slippers.
Where's the candle?
Don't do it. You'll cut your hand. Come here. I'll sweep it.
I looked everywhere.
Just go. I'll find it.
Ah.
Oh, cut your hand. Let me see.
No, it's nothing.
Let me see. There's a piece of glass in it.
No.
Let me bandage it.
Ow, no, no, no. There's no need.
Oops, it, oh, it's cut so badly. It should be sterilized.
Oh, it's okay.
Just turn your hand.
Their voices are lost in the darkness, and the sound of her thoughts are heard in the form of a whisper, which is harmonized with the sound of fizzling sausages and hot oil.
Why don't I think that I should tell him? I can bear the pain of this secret until the end of my life, but he may know it. No, I should not think about keeping this secret. I should begin to speak about it by combining it with a memory or something. How then? What should I do if something happens? Is it possible to tell him these things after such a long time?
Scene 3, first night. Sound of fizzling is still heard. The man tries to write down with his bandaged finger. The woman brings him a piece of sausage.
Well fried.
I'm full.
Just taste it.
You had dinner at work, didn't you?
It's Bulgarian sausage, the one you like the best.
The man tastes it with surprise.
Just try it, okay? Is it okay?
She goes to the kitchen in a hurry without waiting for the man's response. The man is playing with his bandage. He's still surprised.
Do you remember when we bought that candle?
The fizzling of the food. The fizzling of the food, which is burning.
I'll never forget it.
The fizzling of the food, which is burning. It's burning.
We've only lit it one time.
It's burning, and we...
You don't remember?
We're all fed up with each other. The fizzling of the food, the burning, and we're fed up.